What's up, you guys? This is Jay Younger 2 back with another video, and in this video, I'm going to be discussing the truth about Fred VanVleet. Hope you guys don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more basketball content. Have a good day. Let's get into the video. Fred VanVleet has an amazing NBA story. This guy, he's been in the G League for a while, and he was going back and forth into the NBA, but he finally solidified himself for the Toronto Raptors. And really, one thing that you have to give the Raptors credit for is their developmental system. If you've seen, they've had many NBA players over the years: Pascal Siakam, Norman Powell, DeMar DeRozan, all of the guys who they've had, even their best players. They've definitely truly developed them into becoming great, talented NBA players. And another one of those guys, of course, is Fred VanVleet. Fred VanVleet has drastically improved since his rookie season, from averaging just 2.9 points per game to now averaging over 17 points per game for a very talented Toronto Raptors team that still played very well this season despite getting eliminated in the second round. One thing though that's going really good for Fred VanVleet is that this guy is only 26 years old. So this man is about to enter his prime as a basketball player. And I was listening to JJ Redick's podcast, and when Fred VanVleet, he was on there, he was talking obviously about free agency, and he's looking to get paid this summer. And the talent and level of a player he is, and he's continually getting better. There's many teams out there that want Fred VanVleet over free agency, but the one team who I feel like who can possibly land Fred VanVleet is the Los Angeles Clippers. Now the Clippers, they've been talking about getting another point guard, a guy who can facilitate the offense. And you know, they were talking about getting Rajon Rondo. Rajon Rondo will be an amazing fit for the Los Angeles Clippers because he provides everything that they need. But if you want a guy who can also do the same thing, that guy could possibly be Fred VanVleet. Fred VanVleet is a pretty solid defender, and he definitely made that case in the series against the Golden State Warriors in the 2019 NBA Finals. Yeah, he did guard Steph Curry, but he was getting buckets on Steph Curry. But not only that, but he was defending Steph Curry at the best level that he could. But he definitely made some big shots when it mattered the most for the Raptors. And in a lot of clutch situations, sometimes he's asked to make the game-winning shot. But signing Fred VanVleet on the Los Angeles Clippers would definitely be a tricky situation because you have Montrezl Harrell, who as well is a free agent. And the Clippers possibly might re-sign Montrezl Harrell to another pretty big deal. This man, he just won Sixth Man of the Year. And he's definitely established himself as one of the most, you know, underrated power forwards in the game. But if Fred VanVleet is really truly looking to get paid this summer, you have teams out there, obviously, sadly, like the New York Knicks, who can offer Fred VanVleet a lot of money. You have the Detroit Pistons is another team that can offer Fred VanVleet a lot of money. And he said himself that he can go out and lead an offense and he can be one of the team's best players. So personally, in my opinion, if Fred VanVleet really truly wants to be a man of a team, then he can go to one of those teams and be, you know, like a face of a franchise, because this guy, he's definitely a lot better than I think people would give him credit to be, especially being on a very, very talented, loaded Raptors team still. I feel like if Fred VanVleet was definitely a face of a team and one of the league's, you know, best players on the team, he can definitely be an all-star. And he was a borderline all-star this season already for this Toronto Raptors team. But going back on the subject with the Clippers, going to the Clippers will be another really, really big piece for this team if they could possibly get Fred VanVleet. Fred VanVleet will basically provide pretty much everything what they need. They need a guy who can facilitate. He can facilitate and run the offense. They need a guy who can get buckets. Fred VanVleet can go out and get you 15, 16 points per game for that Clippers team. And the Clippers, they already have a really talented team on paper. When you look at the team, they really should be the best team in basketball. Adding Fred VanVleet is like adding basically another third star player. But the Toronto Raptors definitely are going to do everything in their power to keep Fred VanVleet on their roster, because Fred VanVleet is definitely one of the league's up-and-coming best players. This guy is very talented, and like I said before, he's only 26 years old, so he's just now about to truly enter his prime, and really, we're going to see the best basketball out of him. But also, just remember that this guy was an undrafted player, and he really, truly put in the work to become the player who he is today. So this guy, he definitely always had that chip on his shoulder to go out and be the best basketball player that he can be. So for him, getting paid is really going to be a big deal for him as well. But if you look at the future of the Toronto Raptors, they do have some good young talent. And obviously the Raptors, as I said earlier, they have one of the best developmental systems in the entire NBA and getting the best out of their basketball players. So staying in Toronto wouldn't necessarily be a bad idea, despite them having some older veterans on the roster like Kyle Lowry, Serge Ibaka, Marc Gasol. There's many guys who are up in the age, but Fred VanVleet may want to go out and explore. Because as I said before, this guy has the talent to be an all-star caliber player on a lot of other NBA teams, and especially teams that need somebody at the point guard position. Another team that could have been possibly a really good team to sign was the Lakers. But looking at Fred VanVleet, he's definitely a guy who can compete at a very high level on a championship level team, especially getting him on a team like the Clippers will be a really big deal for them, and that could definitely put them over the edge. But he can also go out and sign teams that are still in that rebuilding phase and really just be the man on one of those teams as well. And obviously, he can just re-sign back with the Raptors and continue to compete. But I don't feel like the Raptors, they can never really take that next step again with the guys who they have on their roster still. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. New basketball content coming out every week. Hope you guys have a good day. Peace.